I'm gonna take a day off, nigga. Oh! Oh!
Hello, sir.
Beg your pardon, madam.
Drinking or something there? You're shy, big man. Spend some time with me.
Woo-wee. I ain't had a piece of crop in years. Looking at you, I feel something.
Excuse me, sir. You need help? Mister, you alive?
Oh, fuck. God damn it. Good heavens.
Excuse me?
I said, no, I'm not okay. Do I look like I'm okay?
You look pretty good for a corpse.
Praise be.
Move up, mister. Time to get you to a doctor or an undertaker. Whichever you need once we get to town.
St. Peter, open up them pearly gates. I'm coming home.
Oh. Come on, mister. Come on.
Hurry, sir. I'm bleeding like a badly butchered hog.
You'll be fine. Just focus.
You better take the reins. I don't think I'm strong enough.
I'm finished. Done for.
Just sit up straight, will you?
The closest doctor is in Armadillo. What is your name, friend?
John Marston.
Oh, good God! Out of the frying pan into the fire!
Excuse me?
How many outlaws can a man encounter in one day?
You must have me mistaken with somebody else, friend.
The Baller Twins, Walton's gang! I know who you are! Good Lord! It's those scoundrels once again! Excellent work, sir! Push on to Armadillo!
What the hell happened to you?
Bandits! Hoodlums! The scoundrels robbed me blind and left me to die!
I can see that.
Once again, a victim of my own success. They see a man in a well-cut suit and this happens.
Do you know who they were?
No idea. I'm not the kind of man who has enemies.
You do now.
I give so much and still they take. We live in an uncivilized and graceless world, friend. Our maker is a funny sense of humor sometimes. Still, at least I met you. Please, let's keep moving! The Good Samaritan in wolf's clothes. And forgive me, pain is playing their havoc with my metaphors. I don't believe it! More of the gutter snipe! And the love of God stick to the road!
I'll drop the 100 fools like you!
I knew you'd come.
What?
Is that Armadillo? Come on, hurry!
Christ's sakes, man, you're gonna be fine. We're
Take
nearly there.
Me into your arms.
We're here. Stay with me.
Oh, where the devil are we?
Armadillo. We made it safe, you'll be happy to know.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. You're a gentleman and a true man of honor.
Coming from you, I doubt that means much, but I appreciate the civility.
I owe you, sir. And I always pay my debts. Jesus! But if I die, I'm sorry for it. If not, I'll be your man for...
Let's get you fixed up first. Then we'll decide what you're my man for.
Well, howdy.
Excuse me, friend. Mind if I rest up at your camp a spell?
Well, it'd be my pleasure. Man needs a break from this desiccated land.
Thank you, mister. Say, what's that stick you got there?
Oh. Y'all ain't never seen a dowsing rod before, mister? Never seen a man summon the water up from the bare earth? Mister,
Marston.
Ah.
No, can't say I have. It's water you're looking for. What's wrong with that lake over there?
Oh, there ain't nothing wrong with Lake Don Julio. Nothing wrong with it, but we lack the fancy irrigation equipment you folks have back east. So, man needs a wellspring on his proper tie to ranch here.
Makes sense.
Yeah. Why, you know, just last week, I was over at Old Pleasant's house. Now, I think I may have found something, but... Old coot that owns the place threatened to call the law down on me, so...
People act funny around strange men with sticks.
They sure do. Damn fools. Bet you he don't even know how much water's running underneath his proper tie.
You want me to tell him?
You know what? You ain't that stupid, mister. And I can tell. I'll tell you what. Why don't you go get the old man to sell us his proper tie for a small pittance? Then I can find the source of the water, build us a proper wellspring.
Maybe I will.
Well, all right then.
Thank you. Hello.
Mr. Marston, I've been hearing about your plans.
Have you, Miss McFarlane?
Yes, from Lee Johnson, to settle here and build a life for yourself.
I'm afraid those aren't my plans. See, I already have a life. Well, I had one, and I'm trying to reclaim it. Or maybe what you could say is that I had two, and I'm in one of them so the other can survive.
You do so love to talk in riddles, Mr. Marston. Do you do that, I wonder, as a substitute for having anything interesting to say?
Probably, Miss McFarlane.
Oh, call me Bonnie, you fool. Call me Bonnie.
Miss McFarlane, I'm married. I have a son. I had a daughter, but she died. Years before that, I rode in a gang. We robbed banks, trains, held people ransom. We killed people we didn't like. Bill Williamson was in that gang. Now, if I don't capture my former brother in arms, great harm will befall my family. Now, I don't suppose any of this is very interesting to you, but I hope it explains why I wasn't so eager to talk about it.
No, I do understand. I had no idea. You poor man.
Even in this new country, memories don't really fade. My father was an illiterate Scot born on the boat into New York. He never saw his homeland, but to hear him talk about it, you'd imagine he only ever ate haggis and wore a kilt. And he hated the English for what they had done to his great-grandparents that he'd never met. People don't forget. Nothing gets forgiven.
That's true, especially when it comes to money. And you know, even now, after all his labors, my father's debts are still terrible. I worry every day about us losing the ranch. It would kill him.
My father died when I was 8 years old. His eyes were, well, let's just say he was blinded in a bar fight south of Chicago. My mother died during childbirth. She was a prostitute, and he was her, well, I don't know what he was. So I was sent off to an orphanage and ran away and fell in with a gang.
My word. What a difficult life you've lived.
The leader of the gang taught me how to read, taught me how to see all that was good in the world. He was a great man in a way.
But you killed people.
Sure. And I've suffered for it. And that's the life I left, or tried to leave. Said too much, Bonnie. I'm an uneducated killer, sent here to do all I can do well. Kill a man in cold blood so that another man may do his part to cut crime in an area, and a rich man can be elected governor on the back of these promises.
Civilization is a truly beautiful thing, Mr. Marston. Listen, can you help me?
Well, I can try. What do you need, money?
No, nothing so complicated. I need an extra hand to take out the herd to pasture.
Sure. Point me in the right direction.
Right. Are you ready to learn how to herd some cows? Yeah! Hello,
Mr. Hello.
Thank you for telling me all that back there. It must have been hard for you.
I hope you understand now why I've been playing my cards somewhat close to my chest.
I didn't know you had a wife and child. Then again, I don't think I ever asked. They're lucky to have a man like you.
I ain't so sure about that, but thank you.
How do you do, sir? Whoa there!
Easy!
He's got it!
Let's go.
Marston. Either that, or you were a cow in a past life.
Thank you, Miss McFarland.
I'll see you later. I have work to do back at the ranch.
Come on!
You come. Come on.
Well, hello, Mr. Marston. How are you?
Fine, thank you. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you. Did you meet my father? John Marston, this is my father, Drew McFarland.
Pleasure to meet you, Mr. Marston. Please. So, my daughter informs me that you're here on some secret mission to remove some undesirables from the county.
Something like that. I'm grateful for the hospitality, sir.
Well, you know, we've lived here for 30 years now. Came here from the east. The land had never been settled. For 10 years, we fought the Indians. Tough men. Then we had outlaws, and we had drought, and we had smallpox, terrible winters, cholera. I buried more of my children than I raised.
Sorry to hear that, sir.
I've seen strong men wither and die under that unforgiving sun. That whole herd of cattle take sick and die. But I've never once doubted my life here.
No, sir.
When I hear about this so-called federal government sending out agents to covertly murder and control people, then I start to worry. I mean, yeah, all right, Williamson is a menace, and men like him are the plague. But isn't a government agent a worse menace? And all that symbolizes, I mean.
You may be right, sir.
Well, you're a brave man. You're always going to be welcome here. You tell your friends out east that we don't want to live like that out here. And sneaking around and spying and secret missions. It's preposterous.
Trust me, sir. I agree with you.
Good. Well, we won't insult you any further. Come on, Bonnie, we got things to do.
Mr. Marston, do you want to join us? It's Daddy's favorite pastime. Apart from political discourse, that is.
What is?
Breaking in horses. Come on. I hear you're a pretty decent rider. For a city dweller, that is.
You're gonna need this, Mr. Marston. Let's see if we can put that new lasso of yours to good use. That ranch hand said there's a pack of wild horses nearby. What are you waiting for? Those horses won't hang around for long.
Let's go.
You sure have some interesting theories on what the government's doing, sir.
Ain't theories, Mr. Marston. I saw the telegram Marshall got from Blackwater. It ain't exactly a state secret who sent you.
Well, is he wrong? I saw those men from the train.
The government can go to hell if you ask me. Those sons of bitches would steal a coin off a dead man's eyes.
Mr. Marston!
He's right. Now, I don't know much about politics.
Please, Paul, can we just enjoy
the ride? But I know we're only as free as they say we are. Power's like a drink. The more you have, the more you want. There's few men who can handle it.
There's certain things in this country a woman could do much better, if you ask me.
I ain't gonna argue with that, Miss McFarland. So many folks in trouble.
It'll sap your spirit and make you poor, but it's straight and it's decent.
There's no better night's sleep than after an honest day's work.
It's no wonder you look so tired then.
Some deck must be shy of Joker, Miss McFarland.
Who'd have thought you'd be such a natural in Bustin' Broncos?
That was fun.
I think you could be a fine rancher one day, if you can fix it. Well done, Mr. Marston. These are fine horses.
Hey, Bonnie. Amos was saying some horses been spotted somewhere outside of Armadillo.
Let's go, Mr. Marston. We can really do with those horses. Come on, Mr. Marston. Let's head for Armadillo.
Yeah. You never did tell me why you were never married. Aside from the snobbery, that is.
You sure ask a lot.
I'm just surprised, that's all. You must have been quite a catch.
The fact that you're talking in the past says it all.
No, that's not what I mean. You must have had some suitors, that's all I'm saying.
Some, I suppose. Here and there. A ranch in the middle of Hennigan's Stead ain't really the place to find a husband. Amos, he's a little, well, you know, countryfied.
Where'd you get your airs and graces, Miss McFarland?
From a couple of cheap governesses Pa hired to save us from being savages. I'd like to talk about more than just cattle and chickens sometimes, that's all. And after my brother left, it was up to me to become the man of the ranch. He'd never admit it, but my Pa's a lot frailer than he looks.
You're worth two of any man I know, miss.
I'll try to take that as a compliment.
In many ways, my wife is kind of like you, Miss McFarland.
Is that so?
She's always been a woman in a man's world.
You don't talk about her very much.
It's kind of painful, but she's never far from my thoughts.
There's my boys. Come on, Mr. Marston. Let's drive them up the canyon where it narrows. We'll trap them there.
Come on, easy up now.
Thanks for your help today, Mr. Marston. We got some fine horses. You know, why don't you keep that stallion as your own, as a thank you from all of us?
Thank you, ma'am. He's a fine animal.
Yeah.
over with.
Hey, miss. I got most of the horses secure and the chicken.
Well, thank you, Amos, but it's the herd I'm worried about.
I know. They're scattered all over the valley and beyond. The weather is coming in real fast.
So what do you suggest, Amos? We leave the herd out there to be scattered by the storm and ourselves left here to die without a livelihood?
Can I help?
No, miss. If the men get caught out in that storm, they're gonna die.
And if we lose our herd, we'll all die, you stupid man.
Doesn't sound like we're left with much of a choice then. Come on, Amos. Round up your men. Let's get the herd.
Dang.
We don't have much time.
Yeah. Whoa, whoa.
That sky don't look good. I'm starting to think somebody up there is conspiring against me. Are you a religious man?
Not in any real sense. Sometimes I tell myself things happen for a reason. Like what brought me here was fate come a-calling. But nobody made my path for me.
We all need to look for answers somewhere. Some in big old books. Others in big old bottles of whiskey.
Believing in some kind of divine purpose ain't gonna give me my wife and kid back. The pastor's who we are, Miss McFarland. There ain't no changing that. Faith is a luxury I can't afford.
We have two herds out grazing in different pastures. We'll need to merge them and bring them all back.
I think we can handle that.
The cows get real ornery in bad weather. It's more work, but I'll show you how to deal with them. We're not gonna be able to hear each other in this rain. Just make sure you don't lose sight of me. Whoa!
Whoa!
Let's take them over to the other herd. We'll try to drive them all back to the ranch together. I haven't seen a storm like this for a while. We need to be quick.
Come!
close. Right, let's round up those stragglers.
Come on.
Let's get these stragglers routed up so we can head back to the ranch. One day.
Thank you, Miss McFarland. Yeah.
Thank you.
Let's go! Come on!
Ah, since you're here, you want to make yourself useful?
Not particularly.
Listen, son, I know you got a mission. But right now, I need another gun.
Why? What's happening?
We've had this problem for months with this group of bandits who are getting drunk and murdering settlers. Last night, they went to a big place up near Ridgewood.
They burnt the place down, killed the men, burning most of them alive, and raped the women. Women folk then got their throats slit. One of them survived and walked in here this morning.
Anyway, we got a posse gathering up near Ridgewood. Will you ride with us?
All right.
Thank you, John Marston. It's gonna be a bloody job.
I don't think I know any other kind, sir.
Hey, wait up!
I did. For a man who claims to have found a remedy to all ailments, he was in pretty bad shape.
His tonic has helped a great many people. It's a medical breakthrough from the East, the result of years of research.
If only it could cure him of his diarrhea of the mouth.
I wouldn't be so dismissive of science if I was you. Times is changing fast.
He's no more a scientist than I am a priest. But people can spend their hard-earned money however they please.
He's certainly a character. At West Dickens.
I can't understand a goddamn word he said.
Look at them vultures circling up ahead.
We should check it out. Marston, Eli, go see what it is.
Ain't no survivors here, Marshal. Man, this don't look too good.
Somebody was so busy killing people, they went and dropped their gun. Go!
Let's stay on this road. Maybe the folks at Ridgewood Farm saw something.
What kind of man does that?
A bunch of weak men. A pack of cowards is the most dangerous kind.
Some men are just born plain evil.
I think it's this land that makes the men, as much as the other way around. Men are born, and then they're formed. At least that's how I see it.
Who could have done such a thing?
Any number of people, especially now the word's out we're cleaning up the county.
Between Walton's boys and the rustlers, we've been spilling a lot of blood.
Look, Marshal! More vultures!
God damn it! Come on, let's take a look.
Yeah. Man, more dead bodies. And the fire's still smoking. Those scumbags must still be around.
Come on! Let's pound leather, boys. Looks like they're headed for Ridgewood Farm.
Sons of bitches!
Didn't you once run a gang of outlaws, Marston?
Yeah, but not like that. It wasn't our way. At least it wasn't my way.
Killing and thieving's never right, boy. No matter how you dress it up.
Unless it's ordered by a court of law, you mean?
This is too quiet. I got a bad feeling about this.
Shed's clear, Marshal.
John, shoot that door open.
Holy sweet mother of mercy.
Came by and took us hostage. They're holed up in the farmhouse. Some of my family is being kept hostage inside.
All right, boys. We need to get into that house right now.
Shed when the coast is clear. There'll be a deputy waiting for you.
Oh, thank God.
Stay with me. Come on, you coward.
There's a deputy waiting for you in the shed out back. Make a run for it when it's clear.
They did unspeakable things.
Looks all clear, fellas. Let's check up on the farmers.
Thank you.
chasing him down like wild dogs. I thought you were supposed to protect us, Marshal. You folk ain't men. You ain't nothing. You're just some man on a government payroll taking money that the rest of us have to pay for with our lives.
Yeah.
What is wrong with this country?
Not up, men. The man that kills the boss of that bunch gets $50.
It ain't about the money, Marshal. These are people's lives. People's homes.
Let's go! Get on your horse, boys!
Hurry, boys. Let's get after him.
Yeah!
Do you think they might be headed for Fort Mercer, Marshal?
What? Williamson's men?
Maybe. All this sure looks like their handiwork.
Makes sense if they took this road.
Come on, Marshal. This might be our chance.
What's your beef with Williamson anyway, Marston?
Let's just say he's the currency in a complicated transaction.
What the hell you talking about?
Some people I have the displeasure of knowing want him dead.
Why does that involve ye?
We used to run in a gang together. It was once like family.
If this is how you treat your family, I'd hate to see what you do to your enemies.
That was a lifetime ago. Bear in mind, he's left me for dead the last two times I've seen him.
Eyes up! You see that?
You just walk away now, John. I didn't kill you before, but I sure as shit will now.
Get yourself down here, Bill. You know you ain't man enough to stop me. You know I don't want to kill you, but I will.
You always did have a high opinion of yourself, John. Dutch always said you were an arrogant son of a bitch. I guess he was about right. Get him, boys! Everybody, take cover! In that shed!
Keep together and stay in here. This is the best cover we got.
Stop doing that!
She's still breathing.
Come here, boy.
Come on, Bessie. Give. Oh.
Norman Deke.
Fuck.
Nice to see you again, buddy. Thanks for your help, John. Norman here is going to help us get to Bill. Ain't you, Norman?
Thank you, Mr. Deke. Mighty kind.
Fuck you.
Hog time. Let's get him to jail.
Come on. This ain't nice. I know. Come on.
This'll fetch a good price. Service to the oldest profession.
Hey there.
Come on.
You're getting my spurs tangled. Farewell.
Come on. Who did?
He's missing. He's only a youngster. My boy is missing.
Where? Who took him?
Them people in the hills. Them hills near Hanging Rock. They took it.
Can't the police force help you?
Oh, they can't even help themselves. Please, sir. My son is missing. I need your help.
If I find him, I'll bring him back to you. Let's go!
Whoa. Sit around the fire. Hear some tales.
My apologies, miss. What can I say, partner? This is dirty. This is nasty.
Excuse me, Mr. Marston. Have you seen my father anywhere?
No.
He went out this morning to ride the land and was supposed to be back hours ago. I don't know. The ranch hands have been out looking, but so far they've found nothing.
Well, come on. Let's go look for him.
Thank you, Mr. Marston. I'm sure it's nothing, but I worry about the old fool. Whoa! Come on!
Let's go!
Don't hurry! I've got a bad feeling about this. Not like him to be away for so long.
Don't worry. We'll find him.
He's not as young as he used to be. What if he's hurt himself?
Your father can still handle himself just fine, Miss McFarlane. He's built like an oak.
You're probably right, but I can't help worrying. He's all I've got. Come on, boy.
Don't you have any brothers or sisters, Miss McFarlane?
I had 6 brothers, but 5 of them died, either from sickness or foolish choices.
And the other one?
He left for the East and never came back. Must be getting on for 10 years ago now. He's a high and mighty banker in New York, according to his last letter.
He should be here, helping you and your pa.
I don't want his help. He can live his life any way he wants. But when I see those city fellers coming in on the railway, all dressed up like a sore toe, I fear a little for his soul. He switched his saddle for a tie, and that's fine. I just never met a man in a tie I could trust.
Nice. Wrestlers, I guess. Maybe the Baller twins, that bunch. Now, you head back to the ranch right now and fetch your wagon.
Yes, sir.
Marston, you watch after her.
I'll do that, sir.
Please stay close. Gee up!
Come on!
What could have happened to those poor men? And their horses were dead, too.
I think we should get back there as soon as we can.
Who could have done something like that?
Your boss seemed to have an idea who it was. Let's just do what he says and get the wagon.
Those damn rustlers! I've got a good mind to head over to Pike's Basin myself.
I don't think that's a good idea.
And you're no better. How many men have you killed?
Do you really want to know?
It's disgusting.
You never met the men I killed.
I heard the way you talk about that gang you were in. Like there was some twisted morality to what you did.
We all have a code. Only some of us don't realize.
The outlaw with the code?
How wonderfully romantic. The reluctant murderer, the noble criminal. There's nothing more depressing than a man who's found a way to think the bad into good. Oh my God, the barn's on fire. Come on, boy.
Know how to handle yourself. Thanks, Marston.
Yes, John, thanks. You saved the ranch.
If you'll excuse me, I've got chores to attend to. Hey, hold on a second over there.
Sincerely, John, thank you.
Well, did all I could, Miss McFarlane. Sorry about all the damage. That gang seems to really want you out of here.
Yeah, well, my father fought Indians. I scarcely think we're gonna be frightened by some white trash.
White trash can be pretty frightening.
Well, they don't frighten me.
Good.
John, my family owes you a great debt.
I think you got enough debt. You saved my life. All I ask of you is this. If I get back home and get my farm started back up, you'll sell me some cattle. I prefer doing business with people I know.
Of course, Mr. Marston. It'd be my pleasure. Well, you get some rest. I've got to go see how my father's bearing up.